This is a special event introducing first from the City of Sunshine, Shane and Johnny, the Dynamic Dudes.
Dynamic Dudes making their way to the ring, much to the delight of the young fans here at the center stage. Again, fans, reminder that Starrcade 89 Future Shock brought to you by World Championship Wrestling and Turner Home Entertainment. Here in Atlanta, first time ever for a pay-per-view in Atlanta. It'll be in the Omni Wednesday night, December 13th. For you fans that are going to attend it live, tickets are on sale now at all seats locations throughout the Atlanta area, including the Omni box office. A lot of fans are coming in from out of town. If you can't be here with us live, you can see it, as I have said many times, in the comfort of your own
home. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing their opponents. Accompanied by Jim Cornette.
Well, we're not going to wait here with the introductions. We're trying to tell you, you can see that big event Starrcade on pay-per-view television. But this baby, Kevin Sullivan, did not start like a normal match, and nor should it.
I've never seen this before, the Cornette film.
Cornette almost having a seizure. That might be the big one, Elizabeth, right there.
Jim, I want to ask you something. I've never seen the Midnight Express with these black gloves on the head. Is that supposed to predict the sky or something?
Well, that's interesting. I just now noticed that. That's why you're here providing all this analysis. God knows I've needed analysis for a long time. But what are those black gloves for? Very interesting.
You know,
double dropkick, beautiful Bobby, the man that will face Ric Flair tomorrow in the main event for the world's title.
Jim, I want to ask you a question. With Flair looking at Muta, looking at Luger, and looking at Sting, looking at all the confrontations that he has coming up in the Iron Man, all the dues that he wants to pay back, is he right for an upset? We talked a few weeks ago about Gary Hart never managing a world champion. Well, Jimmy Cornette has never managed a world heavyweight champion. With him in the corner, with Bobby, to me, the most underrated wrestler in all of wrestling today, is Ric Flair, in your estimation, ripe for an upset?
I think that he most definitely is. There is no doubt in my mind, with Jim Cornette at ringside with that tennis racket, and beautiful Bobby with his great ability, tomorrow's one-on-one matchup, Flair and Eaton will be a Donnybrook. Double leapfrog by the Dudes. Shane with a power slam with beautiful Bobby. Johnny with the elbow. Double team hip lock off Sweet Stan. And a flying tackle. Stan now knocked out of the ring. Beautiful Bobby down. The Dudes are gaining some revenge on what happened to them on November 15th at the Triumph.
They're also getting some respect, in my opinion.
Jim Cornette may need oxygen.
Now, this is what makes the Midnight Express one of the greatest tag teams of all time. They're backing up. They're breaking the kids' momentum. Cornette is regrouping. He's telling exactly what needs to be done. And it has slowed the kids' attack down to nothing.
Cornette's face and ashen white, even more white than normal. And he lays out he gets a moon tan, lays out at night. He got white when the Dudes got close to him, very close physically to him.
I don't think so. You know, I think Cornette may be able to whip one of them. Jimmy Cornette's a tough customer.
Oh, please, Kevin.
I respect your opinion, and I believe most of the things you say, but that isn't one of them. But that's your opinion.
That's my opinion. Here's what I'm getting at. Where are the black gloves now? What is the significance of the black gloves? What are they going to play? Oh, is this the last time we'll see them, or is this something in Cornette's devious mind?
You got to think there is. I believe there is. I don't trust him anymore as far as I can throw him. But you're right. They had the black gloves on when they came to the ring. Now they're off. Where did they go, and what's the significance of it? Colonel Botaya, Sweet Stan in there with Shane Douglas. Both men jockeying for position. Neither can
Is Stan backing up from Johnny Ace, or is Johnny Ace not wanting a tag to get in the ring with Stan Lee? That's what I want to know, Jim.
That's a very good question. Maybe Tom will tell us the answer to that one. Right now, it's Shane Douglas with that wrist lock. A sweet stay with a martial arts background with a thrust kick, tagging in Beautiful Bobby. But that was a great arm drag that awaited Beautiful Bobby Eaton. Great move by Shane Douglas. Got very deep on the arm drag. Came back up to a vertical base. He's in there with one of the most talented athletes ever to grace the squared circle. But right now, Shane Douglas is looking very, very good.
He certainly is, because when you have the offense from Bobby Eaton, but Bobby took it right back with him. That's the kind of move right there, that punch by Bobby. Bobby's not thinking in his muscle. These are the kind of moves that Bobby Eaton does that's going to keep Flair off balance.
Nice move there, stand in, but a backfire. Shane was waiting on him, nice scoop slam. Lateral press, break behind the leg. But he only got one. Side headlock. We talked about Ric Flair. He's got a surprise. He says it's the biggest surprise in his entire career. And he'll have it right here next week. Now, to say, for Ric Flair to say, Kevin, that the biggest surprise in his wrestling career will be here next week. Has got my wheels turning.
It has my wheels turning. The only thing I can think about, Jim Ross, as much as I admire Ric Flair, sometimes when the pressure is on you, and I explained it last week, Ric Flair to me now looks like a wide receiver that's taking a heavy hit. He's looking over his shoulder at everything. He's looking over his shoulder at Luka. He's looking over his shoulder at Buzz Sawyer, Gary Hart, the J. Court.
Even Bobby pulling Shane right out over the top rope while Jim Cornette distracted the referee.
Great move by Bobby, great move by Cornette.
Oh, good God, he broke the chair right across his kid's back, right in the back of the head, I think. From our camera view, it looked like he got him right in the back of the head. That chair shattered. The referee's trying to get to Johnny Ace back to his corner. What's Cornette going to do? Oh, can you believe?
No, I can't.
I cannot believe that humiliation. I mean, the Chadsworth Osborne Jr. of wrestling managers with a right hand. He's about as athletic. And Johnny over there with a chair. He needs a weapon. We stand with a cheap shot on Shane.
These kids are in deep trouble right now, Jim. If they don't get their act together, it's all over.
It's almost like they're disoriented. They've been nailed or confused somewhat. Cornette's interference has played a big part in it as well. Near fall. He's resilient, but he can't get the three. Lane going downstairs. And a snap there.
They got these kids where they want them. Bobby's setting them up. Beautiful tag team combination by the Midnight Express. And here's Bobby. Nobody does it any better than Bobby Eaton off the top ever in the history of professional wrestling.
Manny missing that big leg drop right there. Coming on down.
Get the corner.
He landed on that posterior.
I'm sorry, Jim. I'm supposed to be unbiased. I remember.
Sweet stand high. And so is Johnny. There's where the animosity started. Succession of slams. Right here's a sweet stand. Sends Sam for the ride. And the elbow. Lane is in trouble. They're near the ropes. He got two. And Eaton made the save there, Kevin.
Very good move by Bobby Eaton. Bobby, like I said before, is a thinking man's wrestler.
He's got him rolled up. Disqualified, but they are not through brutalizing the Dynamic Dude. Cornette with a cheap shot. Well, that's got to make you sick.
It didn't make me sick. I loved it.
The Dude's trying to fight back. Midnight Express decided to leave the area.
The winners
question. Well, this baby is far from over. Cornette.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Midnight Express was disqualified.
Rhubarb with the official word that Midnight Express have been disqualified. Let's take another look, Kevin.
They set him up, goes behind for the roll-up, rolls him up, perfect wrestling move, comes up on top, Johnny Ace, referee's distracted. Sucker punches Cornette when Cornette wasn't looking.
It was on the apron, Kevin.
Look at him grabbing him and trying to manhandle. Cornette's fighting back. Beautiful move by Stan Lane. Down goes the young puppy.
The Midnight Express lost it by disqualification, but this war is just starting. Fans, we'll be back. We'll talk to Gary Hart and see his corporation in action in one moment.